So our first speaker this afternoon is going to be Polly. She's got a great testimony to share with us, so everyone welcome her up.
Okay. So this may be a little difficult for me. I have been introverted and extremely shy for most of my life, but that's part of what I'll talk about, and in addition to what God's been doing in my life this year, specifically in the last 5 weeks. I realized how much being shy was holding me back socially, but didn't really see the connection spiritually. I wouldn't let God fully into my heart and life because I transferred my shyness, fear, uncertainty, self-consciousness, low self-esteem into my relationship with Him. I grew up attending Baptist churches with my family every Sunday. It was just a habit, didn't have a choice in the matter. I never really knew what it meant to have a personal relationship with God. To me, church was just something we did because that's what my family had always done. When I left home, I continued the habit off and on through college, but still didn't know what it really meant. I graduated from college in 2001 with an architecture degree during an economic downturn. During my year and a half job search, I came across Proverbs 3, 5 through 6 one day when I was getting discouraged and searching through the Bible for some direction. It reads, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to Him and He will make your path straight." These verses have become a touchstone for me ever since then. They give me guidance and point me back to what is important. I moved to St. Louis for my job at Kuhlman Design Group 11 years ago. And starting out, I said what I'm sure most new graduates have said. I'll be here for a year or so, but then I'll move on to something better. But God had a different plan. I tried overcoming my shyness by working hard and doing everything possible to make myself invaluable, while also trying not to shine too bright because I still did not want to be seen. I heard a commercial on the radio at Easter in 2005 for a church that was meeting at Richmond Heights Community Center. I thought, that's close to home, I'll give it a try. I walked into Rooftop that first Sunday and knew I had found my home. The worship was nothing like I had experienced at any other church I'd been to. The message was something I could relate to and apply to my life. People talked to me and made me feel like I belonged. I felt at home the first moment I walked in. In the spring of 2007, my life really started to turn during a small group that Matt led. He challenged us to focus on something for the semester that was holding us back spiritually. So I decided to focus on my shyness and how I could overcome it. God worked wonders during those few months of focused prayers, specific goals, and encouragement. I started coming out of my shell and realizing that I'll always be introverted because this is my personality, but I don't have to be shy, that is a choice. Hopefully those of you who've known me since then can see that difference that He's made in my life. I've had down and depressed times since then, where I've crawled back in my shell, listened to Satan's lies about my self-worth, chosen to hide, ran from God, let my relationship with God be put on the back burner, chosen to spend my time losing myself in TV shows instead of choosing God. Luckily for me, God was patient and doesn't give up on us. The one thing that I keep letting take over my life more than it should is my job. It is usually how I define my self-worth and is usually what I get asked about in conversations. At several points, it has become an idol in my life, but it is also the one thing that God has used more than anything else to draw me closer to Him, especially in this last year. I'm still at that same job I started out at 11 years ago and have gotten very comfortable there. Over the years, there have been many times I can't imagine working anywhere else for the rest of my career, and other times I'm left wondering why in the world I've put up with it for this long. There have been some all too brief periods that I was totally confident that God wanted me at KDG. That He was really who I was working for and that He would use me there if I let Him work through me. But these periods were so easily ended by some event at the office or discouragement about how I perceive things. So 2013 has been an amazing roller coaster with God. Over this year, God has used four specific events to show me how I should handle my work and use my job for His glory. The first was going to Reynosa, Mexico for the third time at the end of 2012. Going into the trip, I knew that God was calling me to spend as much focused time with Him one-on-one as I could during the trip. This meant that instead of trying to develop relationship with rooftoppers, I put in my headphones and read the Bible and journaled. During these times and seeing how the people in the colonial live, I started questioning what the purpose was for me at my job. Being an architect that designed casinos seemed so superficial and unimportant. From these times with God, the focus of my thoughts and time during January was on determining what I was supposed to do with my career. January was great. I felt close to God as I prayed about whether or not the job I have is where God wanted me to be and what direction He wanted me to go. The second event God used was the Rooftop Women's Retreat in February. I went into the retreat thinking that I would quit my job mid-year when I finished the project I was working on, but I wasn't certain if this was my decision or if it was God's calling. During the first session we watched, I got my confirmation. It was me. God's plan was for me to stay at my job. He has a purpose for me there, and I had not completed it yet. I was so excited that I got a response. I hope that this would be the start of a spiritually fruitful time in my relationship with God and my career. But even after getting clear direction that I was supposed to be a light at my office, I started slipping back into old habits. Not consistently reading the Bible, starting to isolate myself, letting myself sink back into believing the lies that I have struggled with all my life. Like, I'm not worth it, I can't make a difference, and no one wants to know me. But I didn't share this with anyone. I just put up a wall to everyone and plastered a smile on my face and said, I'm fine, if anyone asked. This has been my default reaction most of my life. Once again, God tried to get me to focus on His plan for my career. During the Chris Tomlin concert in March, I felt led to pray for my coworkers and company, specifically that God would work through those prayers to reach them. So I prayed during the concert for each of my coworkers, but after I left, I didn't pray for them again. Just went about my life and continued to isolate myself more. At work during the first half of the year, the biggest project I've ever had to deal with consumed every aspect of my life. The project had started in 2009 and started and stopped several times in those 4 years, but then it became a rush and was moving fast to get built by midsummer. At first, I was just helping with the project, but over time, I was assigned to run the project and oversee all of the design team. This is the first time I had this task for a project of this scale. It terrified me because there were so many things that I didn't have a clue how to do and wasn't confident I could handle. I didn't feel like I had much support at all from my supervisors and that they just wanted me to handle everything so they didn't have to deal with it. In hindsight, I have realized that being introverted didn't help the situation. I didn't ask for help or ask questions. I didn't want to appear like I couldn't handle it. I let this project become the focus of my life. It consumed all my waking thoughts, even some dreams, maybe I should call them nightmares though, during the first half of the year. I was consumed with making sure I did as good of a job as I could on this project to the detriment of everything else. I allowed my quiet time to be overtaken by this project, trying to do it all myself. I also was traveling a lot during this time. This caused me to feel even more separated from God, my coworkers, and my daily life. I recognize now, after the project is finished, how much this project affected me. During it, I felt isolated, but I didn't realize how much it had changed how I was handling my life. When the project was over, I took a week off to stay home and recover. As an introvert, I needed time on my own to recharge away from people. During this week, I realized how big of an accomplishment it was for me to finish this project and how God had worked through it. Unfortunately, though, I had basically ignored God during the project. Like I have done so many times before, I thought I could handle it without Him. Even though I had turned my back on Him, He never left me. He was the one who led me through all the ups and downs of the project. I didn't do it on my own. During my week off, the big idea that He taught me was that I got you through this, I'll get you through anything. Once again, this sparked the fire in me. I started having one-on-one time with God again. I was more confident and sure of what I was doing and where I was going, but all too quickly slipped back into old habits yet again. After each event and revelation, I stubbornly refused to let it really change how I live my life. That is until the Design for Life conference in September. I signed up for this conference during the women's retreat when I was excited about the confirmation about my job. Over time, I started wondering why I signed up. But I figured I might as well go. I wasn't really expecting to get too much out of the conference, but boy was I wrong. The theme of the conference was revolution. During the first session on Thursday night, Charlotte Gamble talked about moving your chair, that if we want to live a full-on life for God, we had to reflect on our position and our disposition. We have to decide if we are okay with sitting in obstructed view seats, as she called it, just going through our lives without risking anything or changing, or if we want to sit in the VIP seats as close to God's plan as possible, no matter what the risk. Her points just confirmed everything God had showed and told me throughout the year about my job. I started journaling right then, wondering why I keep running from what He has called me to do. At the end of the session, I texted my best friend that I work with and told her that God was confirming to me that I'm supposed to have the job I have to change my attitude, I have to be a light, and through this, He can change our firm. I felt confident that if I was obedient to what He told me, that He could do amazing things in my firm. But even then, I didn't really feel any more fire in me than I had after the other revelations I have had this year. During the sessions on Friday, I was receiving kernels of truth that apply to my life, but nothing really specific to my job. But on Saturday, God started revealing steps that I need to take to do what He was calling me to do in regards to my job. It wasn't one specific point or speaker that caused it. Everything just seemed to be working perfectly together to confirm to me exactly what I was supposed to do to change. The words to the worship songs had new meanings. The speaker's insights resonated stronger. My focus was sharper than it had been during any of the other sessions or any other time during the year. I started scribbling ideas and specific notes about the sessions around the session notes I was writing down. I couldn't stop smiling about how I was feeling. I was so excited. Going into the final session, I was so pumped. The worship times had more meaning to me than any other worship times ever had. I felt connected to God like never before and was joyfully raising my hands and moving to the beat. I couldn't believe how I was feeling. I had so many exciting thoughts and ideas running through my head that I wanted to share with everyone. I went to sleep that night excited. I woke up excited. I was excited to go to church and share with whoever would listen. I was even excited to go back to work on Monday, which hadn't happened in a very long time. And I was excited to start what I started calling the KDG revolution. So the two specific things God revealed to me during DFL are that I'm supposed to be a light at KDG, the company I work for, that I will, if I will obey his actions that he calls me to, he will change things for the better, and that I am to lead a small group focused on being a light in the workplace. This seed had been planted earlier in the year, but I was stubborn and had not taken it seriously. I've never had the confidence to lead a small group, but now I know I won't be doing it alone, that God will be there. So after DFL, I've been focusing on praying for my coworkers and being positive and encouraging at work. I've had a few great God conversations with coworkers this past month that I would never have had before. I would always have run from those situations. A couple of specific things that I have done are that for Bosses Day, I wrote thank you notes to the two people I consider my bosses and brought them their favorite Starbucks drinks. There have been several times that I wanted to let them know how much I appreciated them or do something special for them, but that is just something we don't do. So I would always chicken out. My advice to you is that if you feel like you should let someone know that you appreciate them at work, you should do it. That my bosses appreciate what I did for them. Or share some joy by bringing a coworker a special treat for no reason. Another thing I have chickened out doing over the years, but after DFL, decided I had nothing to lose, was asking if my firm would financially support me to go to Mexico. The company wasn't able to support me directly, but they decided to do a casual Friday fundraiser for me. It was this past Friday, and people could donate $5 and wear jeans for the day. I don't yet know how much money was raised, but in my mind, that is secondary. If the company would have just given me the money, it would have been great, but turns out this was even better, because I got to write a letter explaining the trip to all my coworkers and share the reason we go on this trip is to share the love of Christ. Maybe this will plant a seed with one of my coworkers, but at least I got to share how God uses me to serve others and how he has changed me through the trips I've been on. I certainly don't have all the answers about how to live out faith at work, but I know trying to hide our faith while at work hurts everyone. We aren't being who God calls us to be. We aren't giving others we interact with the opportunity to see God. We aren't sharing God's love with those who may not see it otherwise. For those of us who work outside the home, our jobs are a mission field. We should approach each day as an opportunity to show God to those we spend so much time with. If any of you want to talk about how to connect work and faith or about your job, I'd love to talk. But like I said, I don't have all the answers. I have never felt this excited before. I believe that God has revealed my purpose for this time in my life. I'm so excited about how God will use the new determination and fire in my heart. My prayer is that I will not be stubborn like I have been every other time in my life that God has tried to show me his plan, and that I will joyfully follow no matter what the risk. One of the ways for me to follow through and not fall back into my stubborn ways is to share my story and to not hide. Because the past has shown that hiding behind the wall of I'm fine doesn't work. So please, when you see me, ask me how work is going, but more specifically, how God is working through me at my job. It will now be a joy to discuss work, because it's not just work anymore, it's God's work.